So use L'Hopital's rule, we need indeterminate forms 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity. So because we have x in the base and x in the power, first let me put f of x equals x to power m over x squared minus 1. Next, I will take natural logarithm of both sides. So we will have natural logarithm of f of x is equal natural logarithm of x to power m over x squared minus 1. Now, from properties of natural logarithm, we can rewrite this, that this is equal m over x squared minus 1 times natural logarithm of x. This is equal m times natural logarithm of x over x squared minus 1. So now we can write that limit as x approaches 1 of natural logarithm of f of x is equal limit as x approaches 1 of, we have m times natural logarithm of x in numerator, and in denominator we have x squared minus 1. Now, when x approaches 1, we have, in denominator will be 1 squared is 1, minus 1 is 0. And in numerator we have m times natural logarithm of 1. Natural logarithm of 1 is 0. So this is equal 0 times m, so we have 0 over 0. Now when we have indeterminate form 0 over 0, we can use L'Hopital's rule. So we have to copy limit as x approaches 1. And now we have to find derivative of function which is in numerator and derivative of function which is in denominator. So we have m times natural logarithm of x. M is constant, so we have to just copy this m, and derivative of natural logarithm of x is 1 over x. Now derivative of denominator. Derivative of x squared is 2x. Derivative of 1 is 0, we don't have to write. So this is equal, we have limit as x approaches 1, and we will have in numerator m, and we can take down this per x, so will be 2 times x, so this is equal limit as x approaches 1 of m over 2x squared. X approaches 1, so this is equal m over 2 times 1 is 2. So this is limit of our function, natural logarithm of f of x. Now we have to find the limit as x approaches 1 of x to power m over x squared minus 1. This is equal, I wrote that this expression is equal f of x. So let me use this. We have limit as x approaches 1 of f of x. So this is equal, now you will use formula that f of x is equal e to power natural logarithm of f of x. So we have limit as x approaches 1 of e to power natural logarithm of f of x. This is equal. Now from properties of limit, we can rewrite this, that this is equal e to power limit as x approaches 1 of natural logarithm of f of x. We just found that limit as x approaches 1 of natural logarithm of f of x is equal m over 2. So we have e to power m over 2. We can rewrite this because we have here e to power m, we can rewrite to power 1/2, so we have square root of e to power m. This is my solution.